I recently got the opportunity to see a web series that was being highly suggested to me by my friends, but unfortunately, due to my job and studies, etc., I was not able to see it at the time of its release. The web series that I'm talking about is, of course, Panchayat, as many of you would have already guessed by the name of the video. Panchayat is a story about a man who grew in a big city, did engineering from a nice college, but unfortunately, because of his lack of attention to his studies, he didn't secure enough marks that could land him a prestigious job or even a job in the city. But instead had to make do with a job as a panchayat sachiv in a remote village of Lehra in Uttar Pradesh. While I watched the whole series, one thing was apparent to me, that whoever made this, whoever was the writer of this series, particularly had interest in old time series like Malgudi days, for example. This is because the main pitch here is similar to that of the Malgudi days, taking the Indian audience back to those days and those places where things were simpler. And problems were usually things like deciding the name of a child or deciding whether it's okay to sit on other man's bike that is standing on a side stand. The concept is similar to many other Bollywood movies where the hero goes from his well-cherished life in the city to a remote village to rediscover himself. I am of course referring to movies like Swadesh or Mumbai Se Aaya Mera Dost kind of movies. But this one has a sadness lurking underneath. Now don't get me wrong, Panchayat provides us with a lot of comedic moments. From that Bavasi slogan to that unapologetically progressive moment when the real Pradhan starts singing the national anthem with the assistance of a Pradhan Pati. The series delivers many feelings, including dread, excitement and joyfulness at many moments, just as any normal piece of cinema would. But this one addresses a feeling that a lot of us don't even acknowledge and even are too acknowledged to admit that it's there. A fear that plagues most of the Indian youth today. The fear of being lonely. This is that fake rifle that Abhishek is hurling in front of your face. This is the elixir of wisdom. Since the very beginning of the series, Abhishek, the main protagonist of the series, misses his family and his friends, but most importantly, misses his life in the city. He constantly observes the lives of his friends on social media who have successfully landed jobs in prestigious companies and how they are enjoying themselves while Abhishek sits all alone in a place that is left alone even by the villagers after the sun sets. He laments his situation very often, going back to drinking in order to numb his pain, and we can't help but relate with him. His melancholy transcends to us. Youth in India is sad. There is no denying that. And let me tell you why. According to the latest World Happiness Report, sponsored and supported by the United Nations, India ranks at the 148th place in the list, ranking 156 countries, where even a country like Pakistan ranks above India at 67th position. There are many reasons why the youth in India is unhappy. It can be the unemployment rate, it can be the low GDP, and there are many distinguished reasons that make men unhappy and also many other reasons that make women unhappy particularly. But for this video, let's stick to the issue of job satisfaction. Jobs in India is seen as a privilege. In fact, the scarcity of jobs in India is so high that none even recognizes or acknowledges the concept of job satisfaction. So when someone says that I'm not happy or I'm not satisfied with my job, the usual answer is that jobs bahut kam hai India mein and jo mil rahi hai usko chupchap pakad lo aur most importantly, ro mat. But this kind of attitude is nowhere seen during our formative years. Yes, when we are growing up, we are always appreciated for some skill that we show, especially by our parents who constantly remind us that we are special in some way and that we have what it takes to land a dream job like, let's just say, astronaut. Hell, in my school time, jab hamare ek sir ne hamari class se pucha tha ki what do you guys want to be when you grow up, and out of the total strength of 22 students in our class, I think about 15 of them said that they wanted to be civil servants and particularly IAS, the Indian Administrative Services. Good job, guys. Students grow up thinking that just because they have a particular skill or just because they're talented in some specific talent or if their teachers or if their relatives one day appreciated them for their skill, that they are destined to achieve great heights in that. An example will be when your relatives appreciate, let's just say, your singing, or let's just say in your third or fourth class when you used to be really good at academics, your teacher said that you are destined to achieve great heights in it. Moments like these indeed feel special to us, and we sometimes make the mistake of letting these moments decide our career path. Every year, hundreds of people come in big cities like Mumbai. Thousands of people participate in contests like Indian Idol or Dance India Dance, etc. And close to 1 million people sit in competitive exams like the IAS or CAT, thinking and believing that they are special in some way. And guess what? The majority of them fail, which is okay. Everyone should be given an opportunity to try their skill and see if they have their talents or not. But some bet their entire careers on it. I met a guy once who was preparing for some competitive exam. I'm not gonna say his name. And he did his BA. He was a BA graduate and he did his BA from a really remote college. I don't think anyone would have even heard of it. And he scored, I think, about 35% in that, just above the lower limit of the passing percentage. And he did all of that because for his competitive exam. And just imagine, if he is not able to clear his competitive exam for some reason, then what will he do? What kind of job will he get with these kinds of grades? Just imagine. By the time students get to their intermediate board exams, they're given a taste of the vastness of talent out there in the world. At this point of time, an idea incepts them that maybe they aren't that special. Soon, they realize that there is no turning back either. And therefore, what follows is a sad scramble to salvage whatever they could with the marks that they have got so that at least they can get some sort of a decent living out of it. With no employable skills to work with, they get a low-grade job, like a clerk or in this case, a panchayat sachiv. A job that is appropriate for their skills, but it is never enough, is it? Especially when our peers go on to achieve great heights in that very field, it is many times disappointing to see them having a great life while you sulk on your own, with the self-derogatory thoughts coming into your mind. So what is at fault here? Our education system, our job allocation system, or our parents who say that we are special in some way? And I say yes to all of these reasons, because ultimately, all of them accumulate into making our youth unhappy. But why do we want to be special though? Humans are social beings, and the only way we feel fulfilled is when we impact our society and community with our actions. Whether it be that fight that you helped resolve between two of your neighbors, or that one movie you suggested that your friends gathered up to watch, and the fact that they enjoyed it. And the same thing happens with jobs also. Yes, of course, money is the main motivator for a person to get a job, but slowly that motivation fades away. And when the individual is not able to see any impact on his community or his society through his job, he will start to unlike that job, and that will consequently start to make him unhappy. This is what is referred to as job satisfaction, or not having job satisfaction, if I am to be more precise. But Manpreet, I hear you say, Panchayat mein Abhishek was actually impacting the village with his job he was living in and doing the good work. Then why was he sad? Which brings me to my next point, our high opinion on what success is. Let's just take the fourth wave feminism that is going on right now as an example. Okay, I'm not going to critique it, but I'm going to critique it a bit, okay, only a bit. In today's so-called fourth wave feminism, the metrics of what it means to be successful for a woman are being reconfigured. A woman who has chosen to stay a homemaker, who has chosen to stay at home and do her job as raising the kids, as managing the household, is seen as a downgrading job. And that woman, the homemaker woman, is seen in a way as less successful than a woman who is, let's just say, managing a corporate firm. Women in workplaces are getting respected more than the women who choose to stay at home and look after their kids. The classic role of a woman as a mother who nourishes her children with the best knowledge and habits is downgraded as not being an example of success. Similarly, an exception is created in today's Indian society as to what success looks like. It looks like this or this or this, but never like this. When someone's success should be measured with how settled they are, it is instead measured with how lavish a lifestyle they are leading or pursuing. What I am saying is that both someone as poor as a beggar and someone as rich as Ambani would be sad and unhappy unless they have the world to share someone with. In Panchayat as well, Abhishek starts to rise up from his state of melancholy when he finds three unlikely friends in Vikas and Pradhanji and the Deputy Pradhan, with whom he not only does party, hangs out, but also does fights, etc. also. But still, Abhishek can't get over this feeling of an inferior job, which lures him to CAT, failing which he is broken again. Which brings me to my next point. It is okay to not be special, but it is not okay to be mediocre. Yes, you maybe are not an IAS or a lieutenant, but be good at what job you have, and you will see your impact on people around you. To be honest, I don't know why you don't feel content with your job. It can be because you're not close to your community and you're not seeing the impact that you're having on your community. It can be that your friends are sharing awesome pictures on Instagram and Facebook, etc., that you're getting jealous from. Or it may be that you don't have a companion with you, with whom you can share your thoughts, etc. It can be any of those reasons. But I'm going to say one thing. Seeing migrating for job from a well-settled town to a village is not, and I say again, not downgrading. This should be seen as a stage. These kinds of ladders should be seen as a stage, as a stepping point, not as a stepping point forward, because it can be forward and backward for many individuals on many cases. Because sometimes a step from a town to a village can be a step forward as well. In the end, I would say just one thing. Your job does not reflect what you are, but the way you do your job, the way you carry it, reflects who you are. On that note, we'll be taking our leave now. Thank you for watching our video.